a warning. Another cut to move on. Another beat that's so strong, hold on. And I get wicked and then some. Stir up shit as the wit gets wisdom. P-Dog coming up, I'm straight low. Pro-black and it ain't no joke. Coming straight from the mob that broke shit last time. Now I'm back with a brand new sick grind. So black check time and tempo. Revolution ain't never been simple. Following a path of my own phenomenon. Just build your brain and we'll soon make progress. Paid your dues, don't snooze or lose. They came with the master plan and got you. So know who's opposed to the dominant dark skin. Food for thought is a law for the brother man. Tempo 116.7 keeps you locked in time with the program. When I get wild, I'll pile on dope jams. Then spit on your flag and government. Cause help the black was a concept never meant. Nigga, please, food stamps and free cheese can't be the cure for a sick disease. Just the way the devil had planned it. Raped and pillage everyone on the planet. And give them fake gods at odds with all law. Love thy enemy and all that hoopla. Here close to words I wrote. Crack cocaine is genocide of black folk. Who in their right mind ever could have missed this? Damn right when you think seditious and I move swiftly. You can't get with me. The 666 move quick but miss me. When I came off involved in conscious. So don't ask why next time I start this.
Some of you don't want that to stop, do you? I saw you moving. So I teach ancient Greek literature to college students, and about 20 years ago I started teaching Homer's Iliad by talking about rap music. The Iliad is an epic poem composed almost 3,000 years ago and has long been regarded as one of the great works of Western civilization, a treasure trove of so-called Western values, without which no liberal arts education could be complete. But a lot has happened in those intervening 3,000 years, and there's a lot of other cool stuff to read, and I felt I had to make a fresh case for this icon of high culture. Working from the premise that an ancient text would seem less alien and remote if the students thought about it in terms of something they were already familiar with, I showed them what I had noticed as I studied Homer and listened to rap music. Simply put, I argued that many rap artists act and sound like the heroes of the Iliad. They are an old familiar type. Now you're going to have to excuse me for glossing over the complexities of this comparison. I'm leaving out a lot of supporting detail, but let me just add that when I say rap music, I'm mostly talking about gangster rap and message rap. So how did I go about it? I compared what the Iliad and rap have in common in terms of the context of their performance, their poetic form, and the content. And I used song lyrics and images from the rap context to juxtapose with the epic text. Performance. I talk about how, where, and for whom the ancient poem was performed. Students learn that the name for the epic singer was Rhapsode, and the Rhapsode relied only on a rhabdos, a wooden staff, a big stick, to beat out a simple rhythm to keep time. The similarity between Rhapsode and rap is probably coincidental, but it's very cool, and it gets their attention. I go through a list of aspects shared by both art forms, and they are many. Rap, in its origins, and epic poetry are oral forms. Both are composed orally and recited aloud from memory. Memory and improvisation are key components of the performer's skill. For both, the original performance venue is a public gathering, a fest, in which the performer stands before the crowd and with little more than a strong backbeat, entertains by reciting a familiar tale of righteous warriors struggling for supremacy. He describes physical violence, verbal warfare, winning heaps of material wealth, beautiful women, and most importantly, undying fame. And all of this is vividly described in a sonically impressive, lyrically memorable, oral performance. In both, performers are in competition with each other, and the audience determines the better singer. Okay, form. We look at the structure of this thing called epic poetry, how it is built. Ancient poems were always songs, sung to a beat. The singing of epic poetry sounds more to us like a chanting, with the same kind of limited range of pitch intervals we hear in rap. It is essentially a kind of music without melody, built instead around rhythm. The rhythm in epic is set by a pattern of long and short vowel sounds, six sets of long, short, short. This is a simple musical beat, and it is a beat you can tap out in almost every rap song. There is some room for limited variation in the epic meter, like the piling on of long sounds for emphasis, but generally the rhythmic pattern is consistent. I'm going to recite the first lines of Homer's poem so that you can hear the beat of the poetry. But before I do, let's just look at what the Greek says, so you know a little more about what you are hearing. The Iliad as a whole will revel in the excitement of the story of this war and its internal conflicts. It will celebrate the glory earned by heroic action. But look how it begins, by naming the anger of Achilles as its subject and describing a field of dead bodies being picked over by hungry animals. Not much to revel in there. You might hear the change in meter to an uninterrupted series of long sounds that occurs a few times, like when I get to the line about the many souls of heroes being hurled to Hades, right? This change in meter would register as an even more serious tone for the ancient Greek audience and would emphasize the importance of those particular words. The words from a Jay-Z song echo the trope of lamenting fallen soldiers, and notice how he broadens the notion of war. All right, well, I'm going to try to do this by reading the code that stands in for Greek, which I know better than the code. Be fearless, right? This is the idea. Oh, this is the best part. You get to beat out the rhythm. Okay, this is how it sounds like. Do it on your table. Nice, wooden tables. Main in Ie de Thea Pele I Adeo Achilleos Ulomenein e Muria Caioi Algea Thaken Pola Diphthimus Psukas Aidi Proiapson Eiro on Autu de Eloria Teu Kekunesin Oion noisite passi dio et lei et obule ex hu de ta prota diaste tein erisante atreides te anaxandron kai dios Achilleo. Okay, so just, you know, for the sake of honesty, that's probably not exactly how it sounded. But based on what we know, it's kind of like that. Okay. Where's my little clicker? So I also show how epic poets rely on repeated stock phrases or formulas as building blocks to keep the rhythm flowing. And these serve a similar function as the samples in rap, chord medleys and familiar riffs pirated from other sources, all used to help build the rhythm and melodic flow of the song and add meaning and context. These are just some of the similarities in form and performance between the two. Let's move on to the topic of shared content. You can go home and say, oh, I saw a picture of Tupac giving the finger at my professional conference. We don't have time for a plot summary of the Iliad, so you'll have to trust me when I tell you that things get really interesting when we compare and contrast the voices of the Iliad and gangster rap with respect to the similar sorts of war stories they tell, the badass images they project, and the particular sorts of epic struggles that take place. We notice that the speech in rap is rife with bravado, menace, and self-promotion, as it tells tales which are limited to a handful of themes, the same themes found in the epic frame of reference, the superior status and skills of the speaker, the lameness of his opponents, how troublesome women are, his desire for legendary fame, and how good it is to be paid, both in the form of money and glorious reputation. I tell the students that epic poetry is understood to delineate cultural ideals, specifically heroic ideals, which comes to stand for masculine identity in general, and that epic always defines heroic masculine identity in the context of war or some kind of battle. A major point of similarity in the narratives of both epic and rap is that heroes battle each other not only by actions but by words. Verbal duels are seen as honorable substitutes for physical battle, and clearly there's a lot of trash talking in Homeric epic, as well as rap. Achilles has been called a killing machine that won't shut up, and that would be a fair characterization of many a gangster rapper. The battles being fought in the Iliad are several. Aside from the overarching war between the Greeks and the Trojans, the poem is most interested in telling the story of the conflict between Agamemnon, the general of the Greek forces, and Achilles, the greatest Greek warrior. Agamemnon has profoundly dishonored Achilles by taking away what is rightfully his. This conflict causes Achilles to withdraw from the war, from being a productive member of his own culture, and causes him to question and reject its fundamental values. The battles portrayed in the first wave of gangster rap are also several. Aside from the gang warfare, the genre really garnered attention when young African American men rapped about being at war with a dominant US culture that oppressed and emasculated them through institutionalized racism and outright injustice. Their pose was one of withdrawal from the community and a rejection of its values, not unlike the choice of Achilles. In both, the warrior's anger stems from the uneven distribution of justice and power and the inequalities created by the pursuit of dominance. In both, the warrior is part thug and part political rebel, caught up in the moral quandary of being a hardcore thug. And my favorite, if I ever write a book about this, I want this on the cover. That's Tupac. In these contexts, arrogant male pride is an attitude and a weapon. It is not perceived as a bad thing. It is understood to be essential to survival and success in hostile territory. And all of this takes place in the context of fighting not only for your life, but also for your culture, however you define it, for a cause, both individual and communal. So here are a few images from the marketing and media illustrations of rap and hip-hop culture that resonate with the story of the Iliad. Notions of community and belonging, loyalty to your tribe, the notice of an investment in the idea of dynasty. The overt mythologizing of greatness, connecting with a tradition of heroic fame wherever you find it. The delight with self-promotion and visible displays of one's own wealth and power. In both these contexts, what you are is indicated by what you have. Homeric plunder is rap's bling. Shoes. Cool teeth. There's this whole thing in Homer about Nestor's cup, which Schliemann actually found in Troy. And here's Little John with his fancy cup, which you can buy on the web. Along with the pure entertainment value of spurting blood and severed limbs, in this atmosphere of relentless killings, both epic and rap have a strong impulse to edify the loss of life as necessary, even as a holy sacrifice. And this relates to the conventional notion, standard in Western tradition up until fairly recently, that there is no complete manhood without war. A beautiful death, dying courageously in battle at the height of manhood, is portrayed as a positive fate, insofar as it endows the warrior with the kind of qualities and honors for which the elite compete throughout their lives. And if the Iliad tells us anything, it is that choosing the short, glorious life garners you immortal fame. The long, relatively uneventful life does not. However, in the Iliad as well as gangster rap, the delight in the warrior life and the idealization of its heroic code go hand in hand with a subtle, sometimes not so subtle, critique of the heroic code. The ambivalence about the high price of the code can be seen in the subgenre of message rap songs focused on mourning the inevitable death of many gangsters. Ice Cube's Dead Homies echoes several moments from the Iliad and ancient Greek mourning rituals in general. Okay, you can play that now, please.
Up early in the morning, dressed in black. Don't ask why. cause I'm down in a suit and tie. They killed the homie that I went to school with.
Damn.
I tell you, life ain't shit to fool with. Still hear the screams from his mother. Why my nigga lay dead in the gutter?
Yeah.
And it's getting to my temple. Why is that the only time black folks get to ride in a limo? It makes me so mad I wanna get my sword in and have some bodies hauled. But no, I pay my respects and I'm through. Hug my crew,
what up,
and maybe shed a tear or two. Then I wanna get blitzed, grab my 40 yards, and then I reminisce about a brother who had to be the one and only. So I dedicate this to my dead homie. Another homie got murdered on a shake.
Damn,
his mother's at the funeral, having a nervous breakdown. Two shots hitting him in the face when they clap. A framed picture and a closed casket. A single file line about 50 cars long, all driving slow with their lights on. He got a lot of flowers and a big wreath. What good is that when you're 6 feet deep? I look at that shit and gotta think to myself and thank God for my health, cause nobody really ever knows when it's gonna be they family on the front row. So I take everything slow, go with the flow, shut my motherfucking mouth if I don't know. Cause that's what Pops told, but I wish he could've said it.
So the presence of this critique in both poetic forms suggests that as appealing and entertaining as this set of ideals and values may be for a time, it is not really viable as a long-term way of life for individuals or for civilization. This heroic code of masculine identity is not sustainable. And it is the very warriors themselves who come to see this, that it is not sufficiently mature or wise. And at this point I ask my students, so what then? How does one conduct oneself in a sometimes hostile, unfair, and violent world? What would be a better way? And by the time we get to this question, it is clear that this long poem, these popular songs, actually have something to do with the real world, our collective's lives, that they are relevant to our own deep understanding of the world and how we choose to live in it. Thank you.